In this episode, we will assemble the Weber Genesis 2 LX 440 barbecue. This thing retails for almost $2,000 at some locations. So this will be exciting to see what they make this thing out of. First thing I'm going to do is we have to get the legs for the cart. And annoyingly enough, they're at the bottom of the box. It is important to line up the middle of this leg so that the wheels go on properly. Pay attention to that. This point here is facing on the inside, and this ledge is facing on the inside as well. First, take the axle and place the cotter pin on the end of the axle. Then thread this axle through the wheel and then place the cap over the axle. Take this assembly and thread it through the hole in the leg. Feed it through the other leg. Put the wheel over the axle. Put your cotter pin into the hole in the axle. Now snap the casters in place. The next part is mounting the tray, and the important part about the tray is you gotta make sure that the bottom here is facing outward, and these door clips are facing the front. Now the front is where this U-clip is, okay? So make sure that's right. Tighten down those bolts. Now assemble the bottom shelf. You're going to secure the bottom shelf here using plastic anchors, and they go through these holes right here. put the door plugs in. Put the back panel on. Pay attention to the pattern of how the back goes on. Put the side panel on. Again, note that grill pattern that's in the middle. Now it's time to put the barbecue firebox on the stand. And you want to make sure that the gas lines are running outside the stand and all the internal wires, for example, like the starter and whatnot, should be on the inside of the stand. And you'll know that you got it on right because then you'll see the screws for the front of the unit line up as well as the back support lining up against that line bar. Now put in the front and back bolts to hold the firebox in place. the front trim on. Now I'm going to put on the front panel, and before we do that, we've got to make sure all the wires are fed through the unit properly. Now you're going to find two green wires which are hooked up to the switch. This will control the lights are on the knobs. You'll see a red and black wire which controls the power to the lights that are on the panel. And then you'll also see two green wires which are designed for the eye grill option. Now, even on this $2,000 unit, the eye grill option is optional, and you have to pay that for that separately. So it's rather amazing that you know, $2,000 unit doesn't contain all the bells and whistles. But in this particular unit, the eye grill is not included, and you have to purchase that separately. So, but they supply you the cables here, and you got to make sure that that is routed through the unit. You gotta get it around the gas cord and then hook it up to the power box down below. So basically you gotta feed these wires through there and then through the hole in the main tray. Once the wires are through, then you can clip on the front display using these two square holes on either side, on the left and on the right. You just clip it onto that. And then we can tighten the unit using the screws at the bottom of this front panel. Now we have to hook those wires up to the power supply, and there are again two green wires which are designed for the switch. Those can be plugged into the box in either order, and there's a red and a black one which are specifically designed to be plugged in for the power, and that must be properly connected there, because you don't want to reverse the polarity on that. Now attach the light assembly to the side of the case.
on.